Hey, this is Tim Strange, and you're listening to SWN. See how that goes. Hello, and welcome to the SWN podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy. I'm trying a different way to record this time, using my phone. I have not got the tripod with me, and to be honest, this is not even me going to the show. I am off to Huntley this morning to go collect a Christmas present for my son. So before I do that, then before we go W3L this afternoon, I'm going to go do that. So I thought I'd do a little preview bit kind of here. I might do a little bit when I'm going to the show as well. It's really just down to how I'm going to the show, whether I might just bloody walk, you know what? Promote some healthiness and go walking. But if not, I'll still be driving. So, tonight, this afternoon, 1:30, Worldwide Wrestling League are back for their season premiere of Wrestling Showdown. And I will be going to that show. I won tickets. I entered a competition through Northern Scots. And I was going to buy my ticket, but this popped up. I thought, oh, I'll enter it. And the closing date was the 18th, the show was the 22nd. I thought, oh, I'll chance it, I'll just wait until, see if I've won the competition. I won the competition, so I won two tickets to W3L this afternoon. So, boost for me. I got a Chinese that night, I was well excited. Because I cancelled out, I still spent the same amount of money. And I got a Chinese. So, I'm going to see W3L. There's only one match announced, as far as I remember. Which was Mayhem Brooks challenging Craig Stevens once again for the W3L Breakout Championship. So I'm excited for that one, because it has to be, right? This has to be the time that we see Mayhem Brooks become W3L Breakout Champion. He almost won it at Bishop Mill Hall last year, and he's put in some solid showing, especially the Elgin shows. He's been great on the Elgin shows that I've seen him wrestle on, and now he's going to go for the big title. He's going to go for the rematch against Craig Stevens, who hasn't had a great weekend in W3L, as I've been seeing from the results of the show, which I've been able to get. Thank you very much to those who've been said to be results for Resolution Night 1 and Night 2. So he lost the tag titles. Craig Stevens lost tag titles to the team of, and I'm blanking, that's super annoying, but I know they lost him, I'll remember to the next bit. Lost tag titles, team Brad and Shane instead of his usual tag team partner, and then second night, they ended up losing again, I think in their tag team match. I think one of them was Saqib Ali, possibly, an old foe. Could be totally wrong, all this information, I'm just kind of, I'm trying to remember as I'm trying to concentrate on the road. So he's coming off some heavy losses. He's now got next to no belts. He's just got the two belts now that he's been parading with. So he's not coming in with a good track record, a good win-loss record recently. So Mayhem Brooks could finally get his hands on some gold for the first time. And I'll be excited to see that, because I've seen Mayhem grow as a performer. The first time I saw him wrestle for W3L, he didn't really light any fires. He was kind of this cocky Conor McGregor type. Didn't really announce to me from Elgin and then came out as a bad guy. It just didn't really do anything. It didn't work. But I think that was more like there was a lot of mitigating factors that night, because that was the night that their van was locked. They couldn't get their original ring. They arrived an hour or two late. It was just a disaster of a night. So that was probably didn't help matters on that particular show. But see him embrace being the hometown guy, being the guy that's from Elgin. So you got to play up the fact that you're the hometown favourite, the hometown boy. It's been incredible. His match with Craig Stevens, I think it was December, was it last year? Was great. There was a lot of friends and family clearly were in attendance to see him, which made it all the better, because they were still passionate in seeing Mayhem with the title, which she didn't that night, but this could be the night, this could be the afternoon, this could be the day. Elsewhere on the show, there's not much more announced. From what I've seen from the results, we could have Krieger. Krieger's the new W3L Wrestling Showdown champion. He beat TJ Rage for the title after winning a fatal four-way number one contender match on night one. So hopefully we'll get Big Krieger. Who else? We may get Brody Adler. I'm seeing that Brody's due to travel today early to get to a show. I don't think she's on for Pro 2. I know Emily Hayden is the new W3L Women's Champion, so she won't be on the show because she'll be on Pro 2 Battle Lines and Troon. We know that Johnny Storm's going to be there. Johnny Storm's going to be there, the main attraction, which I'm excited for. I've never seen Johnny Storm wrestle live in all my years of being a wrestling fan. The only experience I have, well, the lasting impression I have of Johnny Storm is the Wrestling Channel adverts. They had the music videos. It was like, Johnny Storm's here, he's the main attraction, that kind of thing. So if I do get a chance to speak to Johnny later, I will probably bring that up, and it'll be very embarrassing for me. That's cool. I get to see Johnny Storm wrestle. Also get to see Joey Legend wrestle, hopefully. So Joey Legend's due to be up here today as well. Big fan of Joey. I've met him a few times now, driven him on this exact road. We've done Aberdeen to Inverness in a car that was just broken. It was a 30 mile an hour drive because I think my gasket broke or something in my car died, and we crawled to Inverness pretty much. I've had a few car journeys with Joey Legend in the past. I'm going to run around about just in case my phone decides to fly away, that'll be why. I've done a few things with Joey Legend. I've also done the podcast with them as well, which was a lot of fun. It was one of those ones where I had loads of notes, and I really wanted to speak about ITV Slim to wrestling and that kind of, I was like preambling with some questions. I was like, no, I want to talk about this. We're talking about ITV Slim to wrestling. So we got that. It's weird that I'm speaking to Joy. I may get to speak to Joy Storm. I don't know that yet. I have asked, and WTL will be very kind to provide me with time at the interval and possibly post show, depending on timings. I may get to speak to a few of the guys. It'll probably be a little bit more organised than last time, which was me just hanging on at the end, just hoping to get someone for a couple seconds. So it'll be a little bit more organised. It'll be a bit more like December when I got Taylor Bryden for a couple of minutes in the interval. So I'm hoping it'll be like that. If not, then it's gonna be a montage. You know, just enjoy the montage. Hopefully the electrics work this time, because. I think it was W3L's electrics that all went to cock and switched off during the main event. So hopefully that works out a little bit better this time. Although it just made it all more exciting for the main event, which was a great main event. It was Taylor Bryan versus Low King Sharp. It was a great match. So it just made it all the more exciting as well. Yeah, a lot of things could happen today. Nothing could happen today. I'm going to the show by myself. Usually I would take my brother to these shows. He's now in a phase where he's not so keen to come to the wrestling, which means that I'm just going on my own until Jack's ready to go to shows. So when Jack tells me that he doesn't want to go to wrestling, my heart might break a little bit. But it is what it is. I'm going to sneeze. I'm so sorry. There you go, audio listeners. I do have some gel somewhere, which I will wipe before I touch my phone again. I think that's it. There's not a lot announced for the actual show today. I know it's the W3L Wrestling Showdown season premiere. Announced is Johnny Storm, Joey Legend, and we know Mayhem Brooks will be taking on Craig Stevens for the Breaker Championship. That's it. There was teases, it's not been officially announced, although it seems to me there's a few run-ins during Resolution. There was a possibility of seeing Mike Musso looking sharp in some sort of stipulation match. I can't remember what it was, whether it's a street fight or a tables match or something between the two, a strap match and a dog collar. So we might get that tonight, this afternoon as well. But that's it. That's pretty much all we've got got to talk about for that show. Last night we recorded the Halloween Hijinks Halloween quiz, which was a hell of a lot of fun. It was supposed to be, for those that are like dipping into episodes or haven't watched last week's episode in chronological order, I was supposed to go to to WrestleZone Halloween Hijinks at Carl Aberdeen. Storm Babette happened. There was a red weather warning in Aberdeen, which moved to Aberdeen South for the weekend. So WrestleZone postponed the event to 2 weeks' time, which I can't attend. I won't be able to go to that show. I think it gets brought up during the quiz why I can't go, but pretty much, you know, I do a lot of wrestling stuff. I do a lot of wrestling stuff in my spare time outside of work, and you know, I'm just gonna spend. We're gonna do some photos for Christmas cards that day. We're gonna go see the fireworks in Elgin, which is taking place on Saturday, not Sunday, even though that is bonfire night. Elgin's doing it on Saturday for the Rotary Club, so that's just why. So I'm going to that. I'm going to be pre-booked. I've been tapped. I've been told we're going to go see some fireworks, and that's it. Which is, it's cool. It's father-son family time, you know. So we're going to go see that. So we'll be able to see Halloween Hijinks, which is a damn shame because I want to see you just get great wrestling for the first time. But it's a packed card. You should get a ticket for it if you haven't got one. I've moved my ticket to Christmas Chaos in December, which is looks like it's going to be quite a packed week as well. But yeah, there's a lot of fun stuff coming up, and I'm trying to juggle some wrestling in the meantime as well. So other things, I mean, this is going to come out like the first week in November, so it would have been probably the day before Halloween Hijinks, weirdly enough. This will come out. So otherwise we've got recently had Will Ospreay. We've got the press pass for Impact, which I'm very excited for in the future, because they've announced, as of recording this bit, that they're going back to the TNA name in January next year, which I'm very excited for. So I think the first press pass I did was it was Deonna Purrazzo in Trinity. And the first thing I pretty much did was, I'm a big fan of, thanks for having me on the press pass. I've been a big fan of TNA, I mean Impact Wrestling. So thank God that future one, the next one I'll say Impact Wrestling, and I'll look like a right dick about it. But you know, I love the TNA name, I love the logo, I'm so excited. I'm actually really excited to get back in TNA. So I think I'm going to try and see where it is with the little free sats on the old Skybox. I think it's on DAZN with Dazen. I think you might need a subscription. So I'm going to try to find a way to watch Impact Wrestling again, because they've got great talent, and they've been so great with things like the press passes for and helping out with getting things like a chat with Moose. Hoping to get more things like that in the future as well through that, because it's a fun little thing. We do the Scottish wrestling stuff. I love the Scottish wrestling. That's my bread and butter. That's what I do. It's the thing I like most passionate about when it comes to wrestling. I watch a bit of WWE, not as much as I used to, just because of time now, and I had to cancel my network because £10 a month and I wasn't even using it, which is a waste of time. I will probably bring it back up again for the Royal Rumble, because you know, it's the Royal Rumble, you gotta watch the Royal Rumble live. That's the deal. WrestleMania, so I'll keep it for that and then just take it from there. AW and a watch, I've kind of established that. I came up today with like gifts and little bits here and there, just so I've got a working knowledge of what's happening on shows, you know. An Impact, again, same kind of thing, but I'd be really interested in seeing what's happening on the shows. I just haven't really had a chance to sit down and watch a full show, because you get Joe Henry on there, the creator coming back for the UK tour, so I really want some Turning Point. So I'm really, really excited to see that, actually. I might purchase it or see if I can get coach for Turning Point, because that looks really, really interesting. As a show itself, there's a lot of talent on there, like Iverson Jane, Big Fat Iverson Jane, that's very much established at this point. Alex Alex wins there. I've heard a lot of good things about him. I've seen her wrestle a little bit, and it's, yeah, she's phenomenal as well. So there's a lot of good stuff possibly coming up in the future for SWN and the SWN podcast and all that kind of stuff. As I do every year, I'll kind of review what time I have to do the podcast when the season ends. The season I'd probably end start of January for the year-end awards announcements. That'll be when I kind of wrap up the season, take a little break from recording for a bit. So I'll review what time I've got to do this and take it from there, because it's getting increasingly difficult to arrange interviews just for my own timing. So it's just a case of just taking it from there. This has been a lot more rambling than I thought, but I'm very aware that the W3L Wrestling Showdown episodes of like the on-tour stuff, they're a lot shorter because I'm literally 5 minutes away from the venue. So, not even 5 minutes, there was 3 minutes last time. So, at least then, this way I get a little bit of a chat with you guys, get to tell you some updates while I'm driving to Huntley to go pick up a kitchen. Literally a toy kitchen. It looks ace in the pictures. It does, but I won't spoil it for you, just in case for some whatever reason Jack is able to go to SWN podcast, which everyone should be subscribing to, and finding and seeing it for himself, going, oh my god, I'm getting that for Christmas, even though he's less than 2 years old, so probably doesn't even totally understand what the concept of Christmas is yet. So we've got that. Don't know where I was going with all that. I started rambling away and forgot, so. But yeah, pretty much I'm going to review. We'll hopefully still do stuff like every couple of weeks, once a month. I'm still planning to do the All About Disco, definitely, and still do the Rest of the Zone podcast. Certainly the previews and then the recaps when I can get into shows. Because, you know, just have to take them as they come. I think that's it. Right, I think I could probably leave it to it until the next bit, which will be maybe the bit where I'm driving to the actual venue and not driving the opposite direction 45 minutes the other way. So I'm going to just finish up. So I'm going to try and covertly wait for a straight for safety and then stop the video. But other than that, you've had about 15, 17 minutes of me just rambling utter nonsense, and you'll probably get another lot on the other side of the show, of the montage of whatever interviews I can grab, and I'll be in the studio and I might be able to maintain some eye contact with the camera here straight. So, right, have a good one. I'll see you the next bit.
2 hours later.
We're back in the car. I got to Huntley back, no bother. And now I'm actually going to the show. So, this is me just left the house. You can see my house in the background. Don't dox me or try to come to my home. So we're just going to go straight to the venue and see what's what. Sure. That's fine. Just causing issues on the road. Which is just what we do here. So yeah, like I said, Mayhem Brooks versus Craig Stevens for the Breakout Championship. So the match announced. We know that, hopefully, that Johnny Storm and Joey Legend are going to be there. Possibly some others like Bodie Adler, Krieger. And that's it. That's the long and short of it. I should have worn sunglasses. So, yeah, there's not much more I can really say because I'm on my way to the venue. This is just me timing it to show you how long it takes. I should have went the other way. Probably would have got there a bit sooner. But no, I'm excited for the show. I'm especially because WrestleZone got cancelled or got postponed last night. So I was planning to have 2 nights of wrestling and now I'm getting 1 afternoon instead, which, you know, no complaints. I'm getting to see some wrestling at the end of the day, so it's all good to me. Let's go to here. So we'll do, like I said, hopefully, I was kind of hanging on before I left because I'm leaving at about 1:30, so the doors have opened now. I was hanging on to charge my battery up on my phone because it didn't charge when I was on my way to Huntley, so that was good. And So I have enough charge to do some interviews, hopefully get some pictures, montage, etc. And do a little bit at the end. So I should have a little bit. Next bit should be the usual bit, the ring. And maybe power montage, some stuff in the middle, montage, and then the bit at the end. That's the hope and plan. But if it's not the plan, if it's not happened, then I can just tell you now that everything has gone wrong. But hopefully it all goes well. So thank you for everyone. While I'm still doing this little journey around, I may as well just finish up with thanking you guys for continuing to listen and watch the show. Our listenership's gone crazy at the moment. I don't know if I've just finally moved something on the SWN website, swnscotland.com, which means that it's easier to find, or I've tripped an autoplay or something like that. It's just now just registering 1 second it listens. That's possibly something that's happened. But in any event, a lot more listeners, and hopefully you're learning or enjoying Scottish wrestling in some way or some form. That's the whole aim of SWN and Scottish Wrestling Network in general, is to get the word of Scottish wrestling out there, so people can find a show near them, they could know a little bit more about the wrestlers that you're seeing at the show. And if one person buys a ticket off the back of one of these shows, one of these podcasts, then I feel like I've done my job. You know, I've done the thing that I've wanted to do. Looks like there's a little bit of nice wee cue going up. Yeah, got a wee shot of that before I go through, before we officially park up. But no, that's the whole aim of SWN, is to sell one ticket, is to tell the wrestlers, tell their stories in some way or some form, and in doing so, hopefully bring some awareness to Scottish wrestling, because it is brilliant. I absolutely love it. I wouldn't spend all my time like trying to promote it as much as I do if I didn't enjoy it and love it in some respect. So the doors are supposed to be open. The doors are not open. it's W3L in Elgin. I don't expect things to open on time. They never do. But in the meantime, the next bit should be stuff montage things. So I hope you enjoy this episode. It's going to be a bit of a, so the W3L ones, because I'm so close to the venue, they're not as tightly packed with stuff at the start and at the end, because there's not a lot of journey to do. But hope you enjoy this episode anyway. So let's see what happens. Let's see what happens at the Elgin Town Hall. It is W3L. Nice parking spot. There's the queue. Not as big as before. Maybe it's because it's an afternoon show, maybe. Well, we'll get a picture shortly once we get inside.
I know you told your friend you're not okay. Tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. Stay strong and make a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray as you fade away. Wanna love me? Well then baby I have a taste. All the highs and the lows, no you'll never be the same. I don't really wanna hurt you, but I can't control the pain. If you're sticking by my side, maybe we could be okay. Okay, okay, maybe you could be the change I need today. I promise that I'm not this way. I'm really hoping you will choose to stay.
I know you told your friend you're not okay. Tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. I'm just trying to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray.
Fade away.
fake a smile until
here I am. It's after W3L in Elgin, sunny Elgin. It's been a storm the last 2 days.
Yeah, yes, I'm surprised.
And I'm joined by Joey Legend in the flesh once more.
Once more.
I think the last time we were actually physically in person was that horrific drive from Aberdeen to Inverness at 30 miles an hour in our car.
It wasn't horrific, the company was lovely.
I don't think there's someone else in the car as well. it was 140, what was your tour for the UK again?
This is my 140th UK tour. And I don't know how many matches per tour.
Does it change for you at all after 140 tours?
It hurts more. It hurts longer afterwards. But it's fun. I mean, the fans are the fans. Wrestling fans are unique breed. And I was just sitting here chatting with a gent. He's been around since the World of Sport days. And we know a lot of the same people. We talk, Chick Cullen and Tony Sinclair and Johnny Sane. We talked about that, but then we can talk right through the WWE guys and WCW. So wrestling fans, when they're into it, they're into it. And so it's great to be able to converse with them. Like, I talk to my family, they know, oh, wrestling, you mean Hulk Hogan? Like, they know five guys.
Yeah.
But you get to wrestling fans, you can really get in depth with stuff that I'm interested in that the rest of the world kind of isn't.
I mean, your match tonight was yourself and Johnny Storm against
great.
With Aldridge and Luke King Sharp, which, I'm not a Meltzer, I don't give out 5 stars, but that was an absolute riot of a match.
Lot of credit goes to Mr. Sharp. I think I may have worked him before, I can't remember, it's been a long time. But he's just high energy. Like, he did so much out there. I was just telling him, like, he's not in his own head. He goes out there and just kind of rolls with it and what seems right in the moment he runs with. And his choices are usually right. I thought he did a great job.
It was just somehow.
And Johnny's still excellent. After all these years, he's still excellent, graceful.
First time I've seen him wrestle live.
Oh, really?
I was not disappointed.
No, he never disappoints. He's a 5-star guy.
But I don't know how he blows out, but I think it's the last 3 times he's ended up with his pants off and he's ended up just in his underwear at the end of a match. And he's not.
As long as he's not a primary teacher, we're okay.
But after 140 tours, though, is there anything to tick off? Is there any bucket list things that you still want to accomplish while you're in the UK?
In the UK?
Enjoy just coming and wrestling?
I don't know. I've seen about everything I'm going to see. I mean, stuff I've toured around. I went and saw Buckingham and the Tower and all that stuff. So, I saw Braveheart's castle and Robert the Brute's castle, Bruce's castle the same day. I suppose the stuff popped up. There's always stuff to do. Like they say, you can't have fun. If you can't have fun in London, you can't have fun. Mm-hmm. And I believe that, but you got to qualify. You can't have fun in London with money, because it's an expensive town. But also, just, I've got so many friends here now. Mm-hmm. Like, 140 tours, it probably would have been cheaper to just move here. but Johnny Stone, I've known him forever, and I used to get him booked in Japan with me just so we could hang out, because he's such a fun guy off camera.
Yeah.
And we were rooming here this trip and just telling stories and goofing around. I've been laughing the whole time, which is wonderful, because when I'm home, I'm home. I have one real friend in town where I live, other than my kids. I spend all my time being a dad when I'm home. They're my best friends. I adore being a dad. So road time is kind of precious to me, because I want it to be with pals. So I found out Johnny was here. This is great. And then I'm going to go for LDN tomorrow for four days. And I'll get to hang out with Sanjay, who Sanjay has heat with a lot of people, but I get on with him. He makes me laugh. So it's less about what I see and more about who I see.
Yeah, I'm starting to find that now, just because as I mentioned last time we chatted, I'm a new father, so it's just turned 15 months I think now.
Ah, fantastic.
And now I'm finding, if I'm going to a wrestling show, I need to know who's on it, so I know who I'm seeing.
Yeah,
so
it makes it, if it's well, worth it to go. Yeah.
And I know that a lot of times I'm wrestling in Aberdeen, and I love the guys there, so I always go.
Sure.
Yourself, to be honest, never seen Johnny Storm wrestle, and always get to see Luke Richard, which is always a delight. Anyway,
yeah.
Slam dunk, 5 minutes from my house as well.
Yeah, win-win, right?
I don't know where you go wrong with it. But yeah, nowadays I'm that. My probably best friend is my 15-month-old,
yeah,
who just goes, "Dad."
Yeah, I know, right?
That's probably the most sense I've ever had in a conversation.
Not an Algonquin round table, but yeah, you're listening to every word.
That's it. There's a sticker in his room that's a big yellow blob that's playing a trumpet, and I've got like a yellow hoodie.
Ah, nice.
And he keeps pointing at the sticker and then pointing at me and just like, "Dad." I don't know where to get offended by that. That's fine.
Well, with my boys, Connor, he's into bodybuilding now. They're twins, Maverick and Connor. And they're 15, Connor's about that tall of me, Maverick's about that tall of me. And Connor's really, he goes to the gym, he lifts weights, he's doing more weight than I am. Like, I've had my hips replaced, so I don't do any leg work now anymore at the gym. And he's doing a half ton for reps. So every time I go to the, and he gets on with people at the gym better than I do. Like, I walk in, kind of nod, people come over, "How you doing, Connor?" He's the mayor of the gym for kind of. And he and I go to the concert, we went and saw Metallica together, and just have the best time. And now I'm going to wrestle on November 4th in Hanover, where I'm living now, in Germany, for CWP. And my kids are now older, because you have to be 15 to go to a wrestling show.
And I think it's me saying that last time.
Yeah, so my boys are going to get to come to see me wrestle live now. Finally, they can come and see me often wrestle. So that's going to be a whole new thing now, because I got to make sure my boys can get seats and get taken care of. So I get to include them now instead of leaving them home.
Yeah.
Now I get guilt tripped by my bunnies.
Nice.
My one bunny gives me kisses every night now. When I go home, she'll turn her back to me. Like, it's ridiculous. It's ruining my hard ass gimmick. When I'm like, "Who's the fuzziest fuzz, whoever was," like, I'm just pedophile. I'm getting older than
that. I know. And anything furry, I'm staying with my dog as well. It's like, try to be authoritative, and then just like look at you and go, "Yeah, do whatever you want."
Exactly. Exactly. They got the ownership.
Yeah. Like, you don't pay anything into this house, but you know it's worth it.
Exactly. Yeah.
But I will leave it to the rest, because there's still people trying to come meet you as well. So I'm going to leave you to it. Enjoy.
Just 1 second. Just a problem.
Yeah. But no, it's been an absolute blast to see you again.
My pleasure.
And hopefully next time it'll be Elgin again. I'll see you.
Yeah, absolutely.
But
I'm always happy to do an interview. Anytime you like.
Perfect. I'll let someone meet you. But perfect. Thank you very much. We're on the way back from W3L in Elgin Wrestling Showdown, Elgin Town Hall. Fantastic show. Absolute blast, as always. You just saw, I got a chat with Joey Legend. There may be a really dirty edit because we had a young fan come up to get a picture during the last little bit, and then we wrapped up. So there could be a big dirty edit there. A great show. Took a little while to warm up the crowd, as it always does. Obviously, there's always going to be a tech issue, it seems, with WTL and Elgin when it comes to either music or opening the doors. But we got there, started a little bit later than anticipated. Opening match, Brody Adler versus Kirsty Love, was just so much fun. We could see Brody Adler picking up the win. What was the second match? The second match was Wrestling Showdown title match. It was Krieger defeats Keeb Ali. Fantastic as well, really great match, always to be expected with those two anyway. And the first half main event was Johnny Storm and Joey Legend defeating the team of Luke King Sharp and Luke Aldridge, which, for my money, not that I'm said, like I said in our chat with Joe, I'm not a Meltzer or anything, but that was probably my favourite match of the night. It was an absolute joy to watch. It was so much shenanigans and fun, the slapstick, and that's all the stuff I kind of like in my wrestling anyway. So it was just so good, so great. As well, then come back from the interval. There was a kind of wee scuffle, open challenge by Taylor Bryden. He successfully defended the W3L World Heavyweight Championship against a tormentor by disqualification. Luke Aldridge came back out without any shoes on, which, you know, disconcerting. But yeah, came out bare feet, and he seems to be formed a coven or some sort of group with Zero and the Tormentor. They attack Taylor Bryden. Looks like that's where Wrestling Showdown is heading, in that direction.
with Luke Aldridge, looking to usurp Taylor Bryden of the W3L World Heavyweight Championship with the raffle, which I lost. So obviously it's a terrible show, and it was disgusting, and that's that. I'll never be back until next year. So the main event was Mayhem Brooks winning the W3L Breakout Championship against Craig Stevens. Hot match, hotly contested, a lot of great counters, great moments, and it got the moment in the end when Craig Stevens was choked out and is no longer Breakout Champion. The Elgin Boy did it. Mayhem Brooks is the new W3L Breakout Champion. You've seen the montage. There's a lot of photos, a lot of videos, which I'll probably use for YouTube Shorts as well. But in the meantime, this is just a quick post-show thing because I'm just turning in to my house here, and then I'm going to go and have a nice evening because I like an afternoon show because of that. But it wasn't as packed as previous shows. I don't know if it's just because it's a Sunday afternoon. Maybe Elgin's a really religious town and everyone's at church. I don't know. But it's still a great night. Loud crowd once they got going. And just all round a fantastic night. So once again, I love coming to the shows W3L and Elgin because it's so close to my house. Because I'm just pulling up to my house now and doing all reversing. And yeah, it's always a joy to watch. Can't wait to the next one. So next bit will be the aftermath. Well, I'm recording in my studio / office / spare bedroom. So here I am, next. Hello, we're back in the office. I'm using my phone again to record. So that was W3L's Wrestling Showdown. I've had a look at the montage, I've had a look at my little rambles either side of it. I have poorly edited over the Joey Legend interview. So, you know, I tried. But no, it was a really good show. I'm writing the review for it now. And there's bits I liked, obviously there's bits I didn't like as well. But when it comes to going to a wrestling show, you expect some sort of variety. That's what you're supposed to have at a show. If you like everything, fantastic. And I've been to many shows where I've liked everything. But there's been shows that I haven't liked every single match or every single moment. But if it gets the crowd reaction, if the crowds are enjoying it, then that's the most important thing. They're the ones that are going to come back and pay money. I'll do it anyway because it's coming to Elgin. It's coming to a local show. So I'm going to put down my £15, my £14, whatever it is, to go see some wrestling locally, because that's because I'm vehemently passionate about the scene. So yeah, not everything hit. There was the open challenge segment that I didn't particularly enjoy, but bar that, everything else was just so much fun. The tag team match especially, I may have said it in the last bit. Oh, before I forget, before we finish the episode, the W3L Tag Team Champions are Iceman and Jack Harrop. And you eventually get that answer in there somewhere. But no, the tag team match, Luke King Sharp and Luke Aldridge against Joey Legend and Johnny Storm, was just, wow, amazing. Because it was just good, old-fashioned, just entertainment. It was pantomime wrestling, you could call it. Because these guys were just out to entertain. They weren't out to do all the wrestling moves and do the intricacies and the subtleties. No, these guys were just going to be big, brash, loud, funny. A lot of slaps, a lot of slapstick stuff. And as Chris Jack has puts on the daft sheet, a lot of gaga in it. And it was just entertainment. And that's what you want. That's what I want anyway. I enjoy watching it as a spectacle, but I'm not a big they've did the tie up. They've worked on this little body part for the whole time, and it's be all closed in and subtle and I do enjoy that at times, but sometimes you just want big panto, brash hilarity, and that's what that tag team match was. It was just so much fun, and it's credit to everyone involved in that match. I mean, for a guy that's been around for, 30 years, Johnny Storm, first time seen him wrestle, we got a little bit of his high-flying stuff. We got a little bit of the flips and the moonsaults and the athletic things he can do. but he got just as big as reaction trying to do a test of strength looking sharp while Lou was standing on the back of the referee. He got just as big as reaction for that. So it just goes to show that, yeah, as long as it's entertaining, then it's entertaining. That's it. That's as easy as that. But anyway, it was just a really good show, really good night, good afternoon, I should say. And got home before five and had my tea at the table. You know, how can you call that a bad day? So I don't know when next time W3L are coming to Elgin. Usually they come around about summertime, so I guess around about then. We'll see them again. But it was just great for that match. Not only that match, I really enjoyed seeing Kirsty Love wrestle. I think it's the first time I've seen her wrestle in probably about 10 years. I may have seen her down Dundee at some point. Brody Adler, first time I've seen her wrestle since September. So two months I've seen Brody Adler wrestle, and I hadn't seen her wrestle live beforehand, so that was nice. We had the open challenge, which just, yeah, it was a bit of a disaster of a segment. I'll write a little bit more about it on the review on the site, on the SWN Scotland site. But yeah, Taylor Bryden has been putting in so many great matches recently, coming up here anyway, especially up here with Guy Hawks and Luke King Sharp and Doug Williams, and that wasn't justice to Taylor's title reign, being put in with the Tormentor. It just ended up in a bit of a clusterfuck in general. So it wasn't great, but we'll see where it goes. We'll move on from there. The main event. Can't go without talking about the main event, which was Mayhem Brooks defeating Craig Stevens to become the new W3L Breakout Champion. So the whole Craig Stevens Mayhem Brooks thing's been going on for about a year in WrestleZone. WrestleZone's got them on the brain in W3L because they had that match at Bishop Mill Hall, and Craig Stevens, by hook or by crook, retained the title. And then it was announced that Mayhem would get his rematch at the Summer Spectacular. I think it was just a Wrestle Showdown event up here in July, I think it was. So he got announced that he would get his rematch with Craig Stevens at the season premiere, which here was. And it was just a really great emotional contest. People were well behind the hometown favourite, well behind Mayhem Brooks. And they got their reward for that support when they saw Mayhem tap out. Well, not even tap out, just choke out Craig Stevens for the title. It was just a really, it's just nice to, there's some continuity through the shows. I mean, it was a bit weird, like last time, in the last show that they had in July, they were kind of building up Mike Musso and Luke King Sharp. And I think that happened at like Resolution, it happened at those events, but nothing was really said on the show. There wasn't even a Mike Musso appearance on the show, not even in a video or a promo segment, which is very unusual. Mike Musso gets a good reaction from the crowd up here, so it was just strange not to see him actually take part. I thought when Joey Legend came out, oh man, if Joey Legend came out and his tag team partner was Mike Musso, we've got a lot of good stuff, and we could have got Johnny Storm versus Taylor Bryden 1-on-1. That would have been fun, but you know, hindsight's a wonderful thing, and we just move with what we've got. We just continue. Oh man, that would have been incredible to see. Damn. Anyway, so what's next for the podcast? What's next for everything else? I think next episode we've got an interview with Hunter Sampson. I recorded it on, well, this, I'm recording this bit on Wednesday the 25th. I recorded the interview with Hunter on the Monday the 23rd, I think that is. So we've got that. And probably announced by now, hopefully it's still on, but we've got Fraser Garvin coming on the show as well, a brand new wrestler, I think he made his debut on the last Source Wrestling show, and he's done a couple of things for Bop Wrestling, and I think Blockbuster as well. I think so he's starting out, and I want to find out his story, and we'll find out a little bit more about Fraser Garvin. If that hasn't happened, this is very awkward, but we'll be fine. Well, hopefully we'll get them on. I don't have any more interviews as of now, 25th of October, as I'm recording this. I don't have any more interviews in my book at the moment. So I will hopefully, by the time this episode comes out, which is November 4th, I will have a litany of Mondays filled with content. Before then, I should have something about Discovery Wrestling that hasn't come out when this episode comes out again. I don't know what's happened. But hopefully we'll get some more people on. I'm trialing evening recordings again. I think I've chatted it in other, I will have chatted it in the Hunter Samson podcast when you come up to it. But yeah, it's just finding time to do evening records. It's a bit more difficult, but we'll find a way. And by the time this comes out, my appearance on Wrestling on the Daft Sheet, Wrestling Daft's sister show, the Daft Sheet, hosted by Chris Jack, will be on, so that'd be quite cool. Anyway, this is just me rambling now in my room. I should really go and do some actual real life shoot work and edit this. So thank you for continued support, SWN Scotland and Scottish Wrestling Network. Our listenership has been incredible recently, and I hope that continues. YouTube channel, not as good. So, you know, if you're listening to this, why not have a look at my face as well? Go on to Scott Resnet at Scott Resnet on YouTube and find out more and get to see the video versions of the show, because they're good fun. They're good fun. You get a little bit more, the Bleeding Gums episode especially, you get a little bit more content for your eyes, because I'm just cringing the whole time when they're talking about, when Andrew's talking about all the weapons and stuff like that you see in death matches, which it's terrifying to me. Absolutely terrifying. And that show's coming up soon when this comes out. I think it'll be like 2 weeks away. So that's a terrifying prospect. Anyway, I've been Billy. Thank you very much for continuing to support SWM. Always appreciated. I hope you have a good rest of whatever you're doing. I'm terrible at the goodbyes, so I'm just going to cut off randomly like this.